Do you use the advanced features in Wordwall? Do you realize, for example, that you can make a game, click a button, and completely change it without even having to edit anything? Do you realize, for example, some of the more game-based types of activities and the fact that you can use pictures in Wordwall and do things like label activities? In this video, I'm going to take you through some of the more advanced features. I'm going to show you some real time-saving devices and really open up your eyes to the whole range of activities that are available in Wordwall. Really hope you like the video, and as always, if you do, please like it, please share it, please of course subscribe to my YouTube channel, and I'd love to know in the comments section which of these games you like the best. And if you don't know Wordwall, watch this video that's on the screen now first, just to take you through Wordwall, and then watch this video, which is for more advanced users. Let's get started. So I train literally hundreds of teachers to work with Wordwall, and a lot of them don't know how to use the labeling tool or even have ever tried it. I like it because look at the way it works. You've got the words here on the left hand side, and then what you've got to do is just drag the word like this. I really like this feature. I think it's really well thought through in terms of actually playing the game. And what I'm going to do in a minute is show you how to create a label. And one of the nice things about labels is that you can search for the images straight into Wordwall. Once the students have done the activity, they can click on submit, and then it will tell them if they got their answers wrong or right. So let's have a look at how you create one of these games. So I'm going to click on create activity. We're choosing this one here, label diagram. And now what we're going to do is click on add picture. That's the first thing you need to do. Now the good thing here is that you're not limited to, you can search for images on your own computer if you want to by clicking over here. But what I do is just click on and use the system that's available. Now this is great. This will be a really good example of what I mean. Let's just take a nice simple picture of a computer that's got a little bit of variety in it. We'll use this one here. Double click on it to add the picture onto the screen, and you'll see straight away that it's put the first number here, and I'm going to put that over here, and then I'm going to write the word mouse, and then I'm going to add another label, and this time I'm going to do screen, and again I'm going to drag that onto here. The next one I'm going to do is actually the computer itself, so I'll put computer, and then number three will obviously go on here. Number four will do keyboard. So we're going to write keyboard, and again keyboard will come here, and we'll do one more, and we're going to call it the stand. As you can see, there's a stand in the picture. So we've just got five words, nicely clearly labeled, immediately done, very quick, very simple. Click on done, and the game is ready. Now just a reminder, if you want to share this game with your students, then click on share. Click on set assignment, click on start, and then copy that link, and the students, obviously you need to share that link with the students. Now just very quickly as well, don't forget to give it a title, so I'm going to click on edit here, and I'm going to just write computer, and then once I've done that, click on done again, and let's just quickly have a look at that game. So if we click on start, you can see exactly how it's done, and again I start to drag the words in. I really like this, it's really well thought through. I'm a huge fan of Wordwall, I must say it's an excellent technology. I've really had a lot of success with Random Will. I'll show you in a minute how you create it, but the idea is that the students are working in groups, they spin, it lands on a question, and then they have to answer that question. Now the great thing is that perhaps they work in groups of three or four and they talk about that question. Once they've all finished, they click on eliminate, that question disappears, and then you can spin again. Now I've had even success using this in breakout rooms. Now if you do it in breakout rooms, you need to share the random wheel with the students before they move into breakout rooms, and then one of them can share the random wheel on the screen and play the game with the rest of the group. Really great, and I love this ability to eliminate the question once you've discussed it and then move on to the next question. So great in class. You can also do it with a big group of students. The students can be working in groups and the teacher can spin the wheel at the front of the class and give the students, say, 1 minute or 2 minute to discuss the questions. Let's have a look at how you make it. It couldn't be simpler. It really is a simple activity. So the easiest way to show you, is just to simply click on edit content, and you'll see, I need to here click class questions. I never gave that a title, but you can see I literally just wrote the questions, nothing else at all. And of course I can add another item here. Okay, what did you do yesterday? Okay, so I can just add my questions, simple as that. Click on done, and the game is immediately ready. Click on start, and then you can work. And as I said, you can use this in class. Just project the questions onto the screen. You, as the teacher, play the game. The students are working in groups. They see what question comes up, and then they immediately discuss it. Fantastic, so simple, so well thought through, and I love the eliminate. A lot of teachers don't realize that you can do this next activity, which is basically a gap fill. Again, visually, I really like it. So this is practice in the present simple, and you just simply drag the correct word in, submit your answer, and then it will move on to the next page. So I got that one right, straight onto the next page. If I put the wrong answer in, submit my answer, it gives me the wrong answer, it moves on to the next one. Okay, so really nice, but what we've got to learn to do is to add these words, and there's a couple of tricks to make this possible. So let's have a quick look at how I make this activity. So the easiest thing to do here is to click on the edit button, and you'll notice here that what you do, and I'm going to show you a little trick when you do this, is that you write a sentence, and then you put the missing word, and then you put the incorrect ones. But the way it works is really good, and let me just give you a example. So for example, I'm going to put, I get up at 7 each morning, and all I need to do is select that word and then click add, and that becomes the correct one. And then I can add a couple of incorrect ones. So I'm going to put I got up, okay, and I'm going to put another incorrect word. I'm going to put I got, for example. We're just practicing the present simple, and that is done. I'll just do that one more time. So add another page, write a sentence. So for example, he likes eating cheese. Sorry, but I spell it right. And then again, same thing. I select the word that I want to use as the correct answer, and then I need to click on add. So that becomes one of the options. And then I need to simply click on the two possibly the wrong answers. So I'm just adding in a couple of examples here, like so, and that is done. So that is the way that you do the gap fill. And now again, and always the lovely thing is that you can always go back to any activity that you've created and just edit it just immediately and change it the way you want if you made a mistake. And then of course you can play the game. Okay, so hopefully I've given you a few examples there. I'm going to show you some more. I'm going to show you now a trick that I realize a lot of people don't realize you can do in Wordwall. This is fantastic, and if you use it effectively, you can make multiple games from one game. So this is a real time saver, and it will also encourage you to try and use a whole variety of the activities available. Let me show you. This is another feature that a lot of teachers are not aware of, and the best way for me to show you this is to quickly play a game and then show you that the same game can be switched and done completely differently. So let's just have a quick look at this. If I click here, in this game as it is at the moment, all you need to do is to drag the word into the correct definition. So for example, that one should go there. As a simple example, okay, and then we've got here the Burj Khalifa, which is the highest building in the world, so you would drag that one in there. So very simple game, very quick to make. What about if I came over here and used switch template, and I'm going to change this one to find the match. So now it becomes a completely different game, and let me show you how it now works. So I click here, I've got the words as it comes along on the screen, the word will come along, and I've got to very quickly find that word. So I've instantly changed the form of the game, and a lot of people don't realize that you can do this. So by just choosing a game and then clicking over here on switch template, you can totally change the way that the game's played. And that can add lots of variety to your lessons and to the types of activities that your students can do. So for example, just to take that idea a little bit further, let's just have a look at a couple of other things. Let's do matching pairs. So we're changing that game about buildings into a matching pairs activity. And again, all we're doing is switching here. Okay. And then when we click, we've got the Great Wall of China, the Burj Khalifa, no, that's no good. Ancient Temple, no. Versailles Palace, Protective Wall. Now, if I remember rightly, that was that one there and that one there. So I've got my first one. Again, simply by changing the template, we can play a completely different activity. Now, the great thing about the fact that you can change the game is that not only can you change the game, but then you can save the new version. So if we go back again to this very simple activity we've got here, where we're simply just dragging the words in, what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on Show All. I'm going to change this to a completely different type of game. So what I'm going to do in this one is I'm going to set it as, let's say for example, I'm going to set it as a quiz. So we're going to do this one here. It now becomes a quiz. Let's just quickly look at how the quiz looks. Okay, I simply choose A, B, C or D. But not only that, I'm going to click now on Edit Content. Okay. And I'm going to say Duplicate the game. So now I'm going to call this one Copy of Famous Buildings Quiz. And I've now got a completely new game. All I've done is choose a different game type, renamed it, and now all I need to do is click on Done, and that becomes a new game that I've got available. So not only can you switch games, and to do that, all you need to do is to click here, and don't forget you can click on Show All and see many more games that you can switch to, but once you've done that, what you can do is click on Edit Content and then actually save that with a new title as a completely new game. Okay, I've got one final special thing for you that I really think is an eye-opener. And that is, you can look at the features section, which shows you what other teachers have been doing. And it is a real eye-opener, because you suddenly realize that with a bit of creativity, and if you spend that little bit of extra time working with Wordwall, you can work out loads of things that you can do, particularly if you want to work with higher level students. A lot of people seem to think that Wordwall only works with low level students, but look at some of the examples that I'm now going to show you. One tip, if you really want to get good at working with Wordwall, is to go to the community, because it stuns me when I look at some of the activities that people have created. Number one, people sometimes ask me, well, can you use this in higher levels? Well, look at this example here, where we've got words or definitions connected to space. Okay, so, you know, pretty high level. Look at the language here that we're using, okay? And obviously the idea is that you drag the word in to wherever you think it's the correct one. So that's a great example of a really well-created activity. This is another really nice one. The seasons, where you have to drag the words in, so it's cold and frosty, that would go in that box there. The days are getting warmer, well, I'm guessing that's spring. So Miss Wolf goes swimming in the sea. So obviously this is probably being connected to some type of story that the teacher has told the students. But I'm just talking about the design of this, and you can see really how effective it is. So lots and lots of really creative ideas. And to find those, just go to the community and have a look at some of the things that other teachers have done. And it always surprises me the creativity of teachers and the types of activities that they've created. This is a really nice one for language teachers. We all have trouble with the getting these, I always struggle with these in other languages as well, you know, first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, etc. Really, really well done, that as an activity, and then so that the students can see the written version. So really worth looking now. I'm going to come back now and show you a couple of other features. Okay, really hope you found that video useful. Please come over to teachertrainingvideos.com. Loads more videos that are all free, loads on the front page, and there's a special section on language learning. If you want to follow my work, sign up to the newsletter. That way you get updated with all the latest videos, the blogs, the webinars, and the online courses. I normally advertise my latest online course at the top of the front page. If you want to follow me on YouTube, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. There are about 65,000 subscribers now, and don't forget to click on the bell so you get up to date with all the new videos. And finally, if you do want me to do some training with your organization, you can actually connect with me on the website, and I do online training on things like Moodle and Zoom and Microsoft Teams and working with Camtasia, etc. And thank you very much. I'm going to leave a couple of videos now on the screen that you might find useful connected to Wordwall.